Hi, I'm Dave Janssen, and we're going to talk today about gynecomastia. And gynecomastia is otherwise known as male breast development. Normally android males don't develop breasts, but approximately 1 in 100 men do develop man breasts. It's not only a devastating problem for men, it's also a devastating problem for boys. As all women have testosterone as a breakdown of their estrogen hormones, all men have estrogen as a breakdown of some of their other sex hormones. And so the 1 in 100 men that are sensitive to their circulating estrogen will start to develop breasts. And once the breast bud forms, and that's a tender mass directly under the brown part of the skin, once that forms, it starts to recruit fat. It becomes a hormonal body that is recruiting fat into the surrounding tissues. Once we get to that area, and although that's frequent in adolescent boys, and pediatricians and family practitioners will tell people this will resolve, in about 1 to 2% of men, it doesn't resolve. It can be caused in older men by medication, antacid type of medicine like Tagamet and some of the other medications can cause this. It also happens a lot to weightlifters. You know, hormone and steroid abuse can cause this as well, and we deal with a significant number of bodybuilders and weightlifters who want to have this done, need to have it done to compete, and want to have a very minimal scar. We can't guarantee the scars will always be minimal, but we use the best and most advanced techniques to have the scar be as innocuous as possible. We haven't had a significant complication with the scars from gynecomastia in the 20 years I've been here in Oshkosh. Depending on the size and the amount of breast tissue that's needed to be removed, there are really a couple different options. For some men, this is simply a breast bud excision. And to do breast bud excision, we make an incision right along the lower part of the nipple and areola, the brown skin, true skin margin, and we make a semicircular cut directly below that. We leave the skin of the nipple and areola intact and we take out the breast bud. For some people, that's only the size of a grape, others a walnut, but a baseball size mass. And this is hard white tissue. This is endocrine breast tissue, and that endocrine breast tissue in several men also recruits fat. And so for some people, we're able to just get by with excising the breast bud, but in some, because of the fat mound that has occurred around that, we'll actually do liposuction of the surrounding tissue. Many people are able to be done in the office under local. Some less comfortable with doing that would prefer to do that in an operating room, either under sedation or under a general anesthetic. The complication of this operation, because it's a cosmetic procedure, is that people can bleed and bleed from that very vascular gland tissue. But you know, once you deal with that and you compress people after the operation and you use ice, the vast majority of patients don't have a significant problem. Asymmetry is always an issue because almost everybody starts with asymmetry and in truth ends with a subtle asymmetry. But we're able to take people and through a 1-inch incision remove a racquetball size mass, remove a pound or so of fat from the surrounding tissue, compress them, wear a vest that's very tightly compressive, a vest that holds that in and prevents fluid from occurring in the area, and allow a young boy to go back to swimming with his friends and go to the beach and hang out with his shirt off once the scars have healed. And gynecomastia is a very common procedure that we do a significant amount of, and we think gynecomastia is an important topic for our practice.